Hey guys, I'm Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media, bringing you another Dokkan battle video today. So in preparation for the Ginyu Force team dropping in just 4 days on global from the time of this filming, I want to briefly cover a topic that I'm sure a lot of you will be curious about when the time comes. That is, which hidden potential skill, whether it's additionals, criticals, or dodge, should you give each of the five Ginyu Force members to optimize your team? Of course, this is all my own personal opinion, and I can totally respect that some of you may believe something different. Alright, so let's not waste any time and get right into it. As with the last video, we're going to start with the main man, Captain Ginyu. As the main damage dealer for the Ginyu Force, it's a no-brainer they should go with criticals for this guy. Next up is Goldo, and I would highly recommend going with additional attacks for him. His super debuffs the enemy's attack and defense, and he also has a medium chance to stun. He won't be doing much damage for you, so criticals would be wasted on him. Now let's talk about Birder. As a nuker, his main role is to deal damage, so you'll most likely want to go with criticals for him. Now, I say most likely crits, because you can also elect to go with a combination of additionals and dodge if you want a more defensive Birder. Since he raises his defense with every super attack, he can get quite tanky real quick, and when paired with his high chance to dodge in the first slot, it could help a lot with survivability on harder events. Now this one's up to you, but I will personally be going with criticals on my Birder. So now there's Jace. Clearly he is a support unit, which are not typically known for dealing damage. However, this Ginyu Force team is a bit of an exception. You'll most likely be running this guy in rotation with LR Ginyu Goku, which means that everyone on rotation will be receiving a 70% attack boost. As such, Jace will actually be dealing a solid amount of damage for you, and criticals will be very viable for him. Last but not least, we have Raccoon. His main role on this team is to tank and deal some damage. Even though it takes a while for him to reach his full damage potential, the supports will allow him to do some nice damage early on, and criticals are still the best way to go for this man. Alright, so there you have it. The TLDR version of this video is that you should still go for crits for most of the Ginyu Force, with the exception of Goldo and maybe Birder. However, I wanted to give you guys my reasoning for why I chose what I did for each unit, so that you can make an informed decision for yourself. Anyways, that's all from me. I hope you found the video useful. If you like the video, make sure to like the damn video. And if it's your first time watching me, first time to the channel, and you like what you see, then consider hitting that big red subscribe button to join the Tiger Squad now. But as always, hope you guys have a fantastic day. I'm Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media, signing out.